Hey there, and welcome back to another vlog. I'm so excited about this one in particular. I'm gonna get really, really vulnerable with you and share my story of how I end up here and why I'm doing this in the first place. So ever since I can remember, I have always been an emotional eater. Even when I was little, I was an empathic child. I felt a lot. And I didn't really understand how to handle those vibrations in my body. So I turned to food at a very, very young age to numb out. And over the years, it really turned into a coping mechanism and a place where I buffered out with. And eventually, as an adult, it turned into a binging disorder as well. About 5 years ago, I have what I call a spiritual awakening. And I woke up one morning and I literally hated who I was in that moment. But I had known that who I was in that moment was a residual of my past and not who I was and not what I could be. And I decided in that moment I was going to change and become the best version of myself. And I went out seeking for the answers. And for me, it was tuning inwards and learning about meditation, law of attraction, spirituality. I got into Gabby Bernstein and finding my intuition and relying on a higher power. And this really was able for me to let go and get out of my way. And through this process, I really learned how to make peace with my body. And I realized the whole time, in all of my 20s and going into my 30s, that I was looking for validation outside of myself instead of inside. And it's that inner journey and that inner fulfillment where it's all done. And I knew that I wanted to really heal my relationship with my food. Now, I made the first step with the making peace with my body. But after making peace with my body, I ended up gaining a bunch of weight because I just gave up on dieting. I refused a diet. I didn't want the struggle. I didn't want the restriction. And I honestly just didn't want to feel like a failure anymore. I had done the dieting up and down my whole life and knew there was a better way. And that is when I was led to my coach, Brooke Castillo, who is a life coach. And that's when I realized I wanted to be a life coach. And I fully immersed in her material, along with continuing to follow Gabby Bernstein, Jeff Lively, Tom Bilyeu, Tony Robbins. And I just dove in full force for multiple years and really learned that it was a combination of mindset, my limiting beliefs, and the habits, especially the habits and wiring that was keeping me stuck. I knew that I could do it. I had the growth mindset. I was in, you know, doing my mantras, doing my yoga, all dialed in, but I kept on self-sabotaging myself. And that's when I learned the model. And it was the model that broke the pattern for me because I realized that I was in control. And that is why I am a life coach today, is because I knew 5 years ago when I started my journey, there was more to it. And 3 years ago when I realized there was another way and started studying this, I knew I had to share it as soon as I learned. But it's a journey. It's a process. This doesn't happen overnight. But it is possible to find peace, to find freedom, to have that an empowerment tool to know that you have a choice and that you can create your own reality. So I hope that this story helps you through my struggles. One of my favorite quotes recently is, "You've been assigned this mountain to show that it can be moved." So that's what I'm doing. I'm so passionate about what I do and want to share this with everybody. If you want to learn more about my story or learn more about my tools and how to find freedom and peace with food in your body, check out my website, www.laurenciesco.com. Or you can subscribe to my YouTube channel. Have a great one.